said, turn it on and off when we're not using it. Yeah. Battery operated. So
okay. I will. That'll be your.
Could you please say he's going to be speaking for the next 15 minutes or 20 minutes or whatever it is, so I know the time.
Okay. You got the agenda there too. So just like you can.
But if you then the people know too.
Yeah.
He's only speaking for 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And I
okay.
Know.
All right.
To give them the view.
Yeah. So, do you want to do a quick? All right. So if you want to just do that, and we'll get going there, then
okay.
I'm just going to have my. I'm ready to go. Okay.
All right. So we're at 8:30. We're going to keep right to the schedule with the speakers. The speaker this morning is our Badge of Life Executive Director, Bill Rusk. And he's going to be introducing you to Bachelor Canada and talk about the hero's journey. So, Bill, if you could take the stage. Thank you.
All right, thanks, Ed. I'm just going to hold on to this because I walk around. Awesome to see everyone here today. And I got a message from some people that are associated with Badge Life Canada. They're speaking in Wingham, Ontario today, and the message was amazing how a couple years ago you would never hear anybody talking about some of the things that we're talking about today, and our organization has two things kind of going on in one day, which is shows how far we've come as first responders, military people, family members, and all the other alternative people and therapies that are here, and it's great to see everyone. Sid's going to throughout the day is going to point out a few different people in the room. If you have the opportunity, come and seek out some of those people and introduce yourself, because we'd like to connect. Not everybody has to connect personally with me, but if you can connect with somebody on our board or that, we can at least make some networking, because that's part of what these are all about as well. The day is going to be live streamed. We live streamed in Waterloo, and so that gives you the opportunity to go back, watch, even though it's live streamed, you can actually go back the next day and listen to a particular speaker. And we've been trying that, and it's been working really well. So we're looking forward to that. Today, we're going to cover kind of a kaleidoscope of topics. We're going to fear, stigma, resilience, moral injury, perceived injustice, sanctuary trauma. We will be talking about that, but Dr. Jonathan Douglas from the Ontario Psychological Association generally comes. He wasn't able to talk here today. We're going to be talking about peer support, alternative programs, and most importantly, growth, because that's, as Sid says, that's part of the as important as hearing someone's war story with regards to whatever might have occurred. Disclaimer: there, any of the topics, some of them can be very dark. There might be some language used that might not normally be used by that individual, but that might be the only word or something specific that they can actually use. So it's not to belittle what the topic is or anything, but sometimes. Some of the speakers may be emotional with regards to something that they say. If you have an issue with that, just come and see us afterwards, and we can explain what if it does. This is the big thing with Badge of Life Canada, is that someday operational stress injuries of the brain and the spirit, the mind, will be treated the same as broken leg, broken wrist. Back injury, whatever physical injuries that might occur, and that's coming. And but we still need lots more work on that. Badge of Life Canada deals with active and retired, both sworn and civilian police personnel and corrections personnel in Canada at the moment, and also First Nations police. I believe we did have a First Nations officer that was registered, and awesome. Great to see you, and we'd like to connect further with you as the day goes along. We have on our website, we have therapist listings, crisis links, and alternative supports, which some of which that we collaborate with that are here today. Our motto at Badge Life Canada is strength in numbers, and that's very important to us, because the more people that stand up and speak out, doesn't matter what the topic is, but in our particular case, when it's operational stress injuries, the more of us that come forward and tell everybody about our either Badge Life Canada or our story, then there's other people that aren't afraid of coming forward and being part of getting assistance. So this is this is starting, so I'm just going to let it play, and then I'll talk briefly about it there. Is that loud enough there? Okay, that is just a quick video to show some of the things that we've been involved in the last few months. And some of the people that were in there, I don't know if you recognize Theo Fleury, and he's a retired NHL player, and a lot of you may know him as a champion for sexual abuse. And we were showing off our ink there in a picture, and one of the ink on his arm is a tribal frog, and his belief is you never see a frog go sideways, never see a frog go backwards. It's forward, always forward, and that's the importance of those type of messages, right? To remind you, so it's not because we're angry bikers or anything like that. But everyone has a story, and sometimes that's marked by that. Those were the two children that were in there. Are my two youngest children. My son, youngest boy that was speaking there, just been diagnosed with his own post-traumatic stress and Asperger's on the autism spectrum. And my daughter, who's here, is we almost lost her at birth, and so that the where they're at today is proof that you can have growth, you can have things that can move forward with. My oldest daughter, who wasn't in that, I spoke about that in Waterloo for those that were there, and she's in a master's program in McGill, and she considers, we went on a kind of a Thelma and Louise trip before I dropped her off, and without the crime spree and the car at the cliff at the end. But we were pulled over, just had finished supper, and she wanted to talk. We ended up talking for a couple hours, just sitting in a parking lot. And she considers her dad her biggest hero, and she considers me because of she knows what I've been through in my life, and she considers me most resilient person that she's ever come across. I'm not sure if she's biased because she's my daughter or not, but it's allowed her to come forward and be who she is, and she is now openly gay with regards to her who she is as a person, and she's honoring herself. And at the end of the day, we know through Badge of Life Canada that we're helping a tremendous amount of people across the world, because we have connections in Australia, South Africa, and that kind of stuff. But the fact that I know the work that I'm doing, not only is helping those people, but it's helping my own children, and that's a tremendous thing to me. And I think that's a message that we all need to think about with our family, because family always gets forgotten about when it comes to a lot of our own personal journeys. And that brings me to the work-life balance. A lot of organizations feel that you can walk a tightrope, and that your work is here, and that your life is here, and that they should both be separate, and they shouldn't influence either or. And the question remains, does my work life affect all other parts of my life? Doesn't matter where you are at here in regards to your job, if you're looking for a new position, a promotion, whatever it is, whatever your occupation is in life. At some point in time, we all reach a crossroads here, and we're confused with regards to which direction we should go in. And at times, this goodbye part becomes where we are as employees and our organizations, and where we're at with our own families. And that's where for Badge Life Canada, that's where we wanna instead of that being goodbye, it being hello, right? So that people are actually coming back into their own tribe. The work doesn't take place in a vacuum. It everything that is up there on the four different checklists are all part or an interactive of work, and you bring that home with you. So when you go to work, you can't switch off the button and stop your emotions and prevent yourself from having turn on emotional numbing, basically, and the vulnerability, and come home and then be able to flick that switch back on. When you're younger and you first started, especially in a first responder organization, you do have that ability, but we lose it over the course of time. So we end up on the hamster wheel, and we're running, and we don't know how to get off of that. And every day becomes Groundhog Day, and we end up wondering what the heck, how did that happen? Because if it's 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 25 years, 30 years into your career, you look back and you wonder, how the heck did I, how did I get here? Just like the Talking Heads, if anyone knows that song. And we end up in our own little boat, and we're bailing, and we can't bail fast enough because the water's coming in, and there's nobody there we're all by ourselves in that boat. And when we get there, that boat sinks, and we end up treading water. And we're treading water, and we end up wearing a mask, for those that understand that. And we have emotional numbing, and we lose all of our senses of emotion. So we, once again, going back to the brain, flipping the switch, you can't come home and be involved with your family. And we end up fighting to try and stay afloat. We're going to be talking about addictions and different things today. And one of addictions for myself is work. I'm massive workaholic, and I throw myself into work and throw myself into work and throw myself into work because I don't have to face all the other things that are going spiraling out of control when you're in that. And the other issue, which is deep to my heart, but fortunately I haven't had that, is discipline issues. We go from having members that we're dealing with that are police officer of the year, firefighter of the year, and 2 years later, an organization's trying to get rid of them. So what happened in that 2 years? If we look at the vacuum, and we expect that things just operate in a vacuum, that's far from the case. Because 2 years ago, you were pinning a medal on that member's chest for great work or accommodations, and all of a sudden you're saying they're the worst employee and we want to get rid of them. So when you look at the circle of life, we say, what exactly is going on with that? And it leaves the member in loneliness, avoidance, and basically isolation. And you put up barriers and a mask, and you say, leave me alone. And who is there to help with regards to those situations? Well, on Badge Life Canada, we have a listing of professional therapists, crisis resources, alternative programs that are available. And are there for people. And our other motto is Real Heroes Call for Backup. And what that means, it doesn't mean that you're a hero in life. Everyone's a hero on their own journey. And you're not a hero just because you wear a uniform. But if by having this kind of day and having these kind of people out, you're a real hero by leaving here and going and spreading the word about Badge Life Canada, spreading the word about that it's okay to speak up and talk out about getting help. And that's the biggest thing, because that's when we actually save our members, and we don't have to keep complaining about that people aren't doing enough, because there's enough people here in this room and enough people that are committed now that we can do stuff. And there are strength in numbers. So you can step forward and be that person, and step back and be part of us, so that you're not stuck out on the plank all by yourself. With Badge Life Canada, we believe in a pay it forward approach, so that others that follow that paved road behind us, and they don't have all the bumps and accidents that we've had along the way. That's the other goal of Badge Life Canada, is to pave that out, so that you're not ending up crashing into the lake and wondering how the heck you got there. The hero's journey. I'm going to cut myself short here, because generally on the hero's journey, I talked a little bit about it in the call to adventure. And basically, here in the abyss is for here on our. If everyone can see this here, if I'll move it forward just a little bit. This is our Badge of Life Canada emblem, and this to us, this is the abyss here. This is the outside world. The thin blue line is, instead of the between good and evil, the thin blue line is basically between people that are suffering and aren't suffering. The black is the abyss. The thin blue line is the hand of Badge of Life Canada sticking their hand in there and helping the people out of the abyss so that they can come forward. Strength in Numbers is our motto. The badge is for Badge of Life Canada. And this is what we do, and this is who we try to assist at this point in time and collaborate with everyone else. So we have lots of people here today that know either are in this abyss, have been in the abyss, or know people that are in the abyss, and you can go home and help them or help yourself. We've got a lot of people here today with that are going to be speaking on the different topics, and everybody that's here, we thank you for coming, and all of the people that we're collaborating with that are here as well, we really appreciate them coming, and we look forward to a great day of knowledge and learning. I'm going to turn it back to Sid Gravel. Thanks everyone for coming today.